everyone. I am so glad you joined me today for part one of our kitchen makeover. I have been wanting to do this for quite some time. Super excited to get this started, and I hope you join me as we go through this process and get this kitchen looking quite different. Today we are just starting kind of where I left off my last video. If you remember, we were doing a lot of baking and things, so we are just getting the kitchen cleaned up from that, emptying the dishwasher, just starting with the prep work of getting everything ready to start with our makeover. And it always seems like the prep work takes a lot of time, but it's of course quite necessary to get everything ready. We're going to start off with just emptying the dishwasher, getting all of our baking things put away, and then also just clearing off the countertop, getting everything put into the dishwasher, getting everything cleaned up, and then we can start. And now, just starting with some prep work, I'm going to start with just taking all the decor down, take everything off the walls, and here on top of the cabinets, just take everything down off of there as well, and just get a clean slate for us to work with. And while I'm up here anyways, I'm also going to take off this top molding, just not really something that I like. Never really liked how it looked, so I'm just gonna go ahead and just take it off. It was super easy to just take off, so we're gonna get rid of that. And I'm not going to be painting the cabinets or anything. The cabinets are pretty wore out, so it's a lot of work to paint cabinets. If any of you have ever done painting cabinets, you know how much work it is to get everything painted correctly. So the cabinets are really not worth painting. Hopefully in the future we'll get to totally remodel the kitchen, but for now we're going to just kind of give it a new look, and hopefully this will last until we get to renovating like we want it. And then next, of course, just taking off all the switch plates. I had to fill in some nail holes on the walls, and then just, of course, sanding those down and just finishing taking down all the decor and things. Of course, this little saying on the wall had to come down as well because we'll be painting the walls. And then next, we are going to be just washing down all the walls. I have this wall mop, and I have people asking me where I got it, and honestly, I got it as a gift, but I'm sure you could probably find a wall mop. I just keep this one specifically for walls. The mop pad on the bottom is just for the walls, and it makes it a lot easier to get everything nice and cleaned. And of course, we want to do this before we start painting. Also, just taking down the curtains here. Not sure if I'll be replacing the curtains or just hanging these back up. We'll see once. Then on to paint. Now, covering this dark red was going to be a challenge, I knew. So I'm going to go over it with a good primer. And I also got them to tint the primer a gray to help cover this red a little bit better. And I think it did help a lot using this gray primer just to cover it really well before we go in with the color. And Chloe wanted to help me, so I let her help me here. And I am going to go over the trim as well, so I wasn't really worried about getting any paint on the trim because I'll be going over that later with some nice fresh white paint. And we did go over all the walls with two coats of primer before we did some paint. And the main reason for repainting the walls here in the kitchen, for one, I was just kind of over the red. I was done with it. It's a lot to have a red room, and especially in the kitchen where you are a lot of the time. It's a lot, and it also seemed pretty dark. It really darkened up the kitchen, which wasn't really what we wanted to have for this room. I wanted to have it a little more light and just more bright in here. I know on camera often it looks pretty bright in the kitchen, but in real life it is pretty dark, especially in the corners, and then in the evenings it is pretty dark out here with the dark walls. So we're going to lighten it up first of all with this primer. As soon as we get this done, we can start with the paint, get to the fun colors. Alright, and now it is the next day. Here is our paint color. Super pretty. I love this color. It is called Agreeable Gray, and it is such a warm color compared to what the primer was. The primer was very cold, and so this will be a lot warmer and a really pretty color. So just going in, starting with the trim, going all around the trim work and the ceiling, and then we can start rolling. Painting with a 5-year-old, kind of has its challenges, but I want Chloe to enjoy painting as much as I do, and we're going to get her started young. She had so much fun painting the walls and kind of painting in the corners and things where the areas where she was able to paint, and she had so much fun. And as I was putting on my second coat of paint here in the kitchen, we had quite the thunderstorm come through, and I just had to stop and watch a little bit. It was lightning and thundering. So while I go ahead and put on the second coat of paint, I'll let you listen to our little thunderstorm. It sounds so soothing to me. And then once I was done with the painting, as it was drying, I'm going to go ahead and just take off the backsplash here. This had been like a stainless steel look, and then I had painted this when we moved into the house. I'm going to take it off now, and then hopefully we can get this replaced with just a peel and stick. And then moving on to our other color that we'll be using in the dining area. This is called Dried Thyme. Super pretty color, and I don't think it'll be too dark. And we'll just do the bottom part of the dining room area, and I'm just measuring how far up I want to paint. That way we kind of have a guide how far up that it needs to go. And I am loving this color already. I think it'll look so pretty in here in the dining room. Colors can be a little scary to pick, you know, to commit to a color. You never really know how it's gonna look for sure in your space, but I'm super happy with how this one turned out. And Jameson is helping me today painting. He wanted to help me, so he did a good job getting all the corners and things for me. And then as that was drying, we're just going to go ahead and get everything cleaned up here on the countertop, just wiping everything down, getting everything cleaned up. and I'm just putting some things back on the countertops. It was the weekend, so I wanted to just kind of put things back, clean up a little bit for over the weekend, get it looking kind of like a kitchen again, and then we'll keep working on this after the weekend is over with. And then one last thing before I finish up here, I wanted to just give a nice white coat of paint to all the trim work in the kitchen, just freshen it up again. And so here's a sneak peek what we will be doing in part two. I cannot wait to show you. We have some trim work that will be going down. So make sure you are subscribed to my channel. That way you don't miss part two. You won't want to miss what we do next to finish up the kitchen. And I'll see you then. Bye.